Well, one of the champions of small business and students today is Dominique Fisher, who is, of course, the CEO of Paddl. And we're very excited to be welcoming her today to Small Biz Matters with Alexi Boyd. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
So today is a real blend of students, big business, small business, everybody in the one room having a conversation. It is such a unique space to do that in. Are you pleased to be working with the University of Western Sydney to help facilitate the conversation?
We are very excited to be doing things like this with Western Sydney University. It's just fantastic to work with an educational institution that values experiential learning, which we think is the absolute key to helping particularly young people navigate how they better prepare for the future of work.
And that's what this is all about. It's helping them to understand what it's like to run a small business. And I've heard from a couple of the small businesses today who said, it is so nice to take a day out to actually think of the big picture with my business as well. So is that one of the benefits that you were aiming for? Is that something you just didn't realise was going to happen?
No, it is actually core. I mean, when we put on a Paddl Games, what's absolutely essential for us is that every single stakeholder walks away from the day thinking that they've won, that they've gained something that they didn't have at the start of the day. And for small businesses, it falls into three categories. One, they get a chance to stop, to reflect, and think about where their business is going in the future. That's something that's very difficult for a small business owner to actually to do, because there's always something as a small business owner that you have to be doing. Secondly, it's a chance for them to actually identify emerging talent as potential employees. They don't know how to talk to millennials and Gen Z now about what the opportunities are. And the flip side of that is helping emerging talent to see small businesses as valuable employees, valuable employers. And then the third thing is hopefully what the students and grads and the, in this case, Westpac employees are doing is help actually create intellectual property for that small business. So they walk out with the IP of the solution that they've gained, which is pretty special, but it's our thank you for them giving up their day, so creating an incredible employment experience for students and grads, which gets as close as we can get them to gaining real experience.
Because really, without conversations like this, how does small business even understand what students these days are studying, let alone accessing that talent pool? Is there something in the big business world that they can do, even more than obviously sponsoring events like this, that they can do to help that conversation start between student and small business?
Look, it's a really great question. I honestly think lots of people have tried, but in our experience, you've got to put them together in a room face to face, and they can't just be talking to someone for 10 minutes in an employment, you know, sort of, what do you call those things where you move from table to table around a room? Those hot dreadful desking. Not hot desking. Anyway, where basically they're just doing quick, short interviews with people. It's actually about hanging out with someone over a whole day. The magic of Paddl Games is that we're trying to create the environment, the tension, the competition, the intensity of what it actually is like to work alongside somebody who you don't know, who comes from a different background, different qualification, different experience level, because guess what? That's what happens in the real world. We're trying to create this here, and it gives everybody a chance to actually better understand the other person, whether that's the small business employee, the large corporate employee who's sitting on the table, the student, the grad, the Western Sydney University careers person, all of whom need to be working in unison to optimise the best possible outcomes for emerging talent hitting the workforce.
So what's your wish list? Would you like to see the Paddl Games rolled out across every tertiary institution in Australia? Let's do it.
Absolutely. One of the things that I find so frustrating is that opportunities like this just, we're lucky to be working with Western Sydney University. We were particularly, I actually pitched into Western Sydney University for 18 months to get this away. And I think it was just because it was so different, so new. They were a little bit cautious, but in the end, they made the decision to go ahead. And why we wanted to do it with Western Sydney University is that we see universities like WSU, which have such amazing talent, but our whole system of hiring has, I'm going to be generous and say, unintended bias in the hiring process that seriously disadvantaged students like those who attend Western Sydney University. These students have incredible experience. often from really hard times, but it goes to shape them as amazing people who can contribute enormously to the Australian economy, whether it's via corporates or small businesses. To actually have an opportunity to show you what they're capable of is three quarters of the things that we need to do for these people. CVs don't help anybody. I mean, the average HR manager spends less than 6 seconds looking at a standard CV. There's tons of documented evidence of that. They don't serve anybody. It's basically a form that enables you to pass on your name, address, and telephone number and email address, essentially. What Paddl.com is trying to do is to create a very new style of experience profile that replaces the standard CV by enabling you to build an experience profile that's made up of a whole series of activities. Being involved in days like this, volunteering for things, yes, in working, but also attending meetups, going to conferences, working in tute groups, working on volunteer projects, or frankly, a lot of things that you might do in your personal and family time that you don't actually realise is such a valuable skill. A lot of these students translate for their parents, for example, who don't necessarily have English as a first language. That is an enormous skill that is of huge interest to an employer. But I will guarantee you none of those students put that skill in their CV. They see that as something that's got nothing to do with the workplace. We're trying to give them the confidence to say, you are a unique, amazing human being. You have so much to offer. Let's help you tell your whole story, not just the bit that you think is relevant to the workplace.
And I love the way the Paddl Games fits into that and the fact that it really brings out the personalities. You only have to look around the room and see each of the personalities coming out at the tables. You've got the slightly louder kids, yeah, and the slightly quiet and just thinking about it in the background kids, but everybody seems to have a role to play, and it's really lovely. Why is it so important to have a large organisation like Westpac behind this? Can it happen without them?
Look, frankly, these are not cheap things to put on. And none of the businesses or the students pay to be in a day like this. So we need sponsorship from large corporates like Westpac. But they're not just doing it out of the goodness of their heart. Yes, they're great corporate citizens, but this is incredibly valuable. We must have close to 30 Westpac employees here. They are gaining unique insights into small business, holding conversations with their customers or potential customers in ways that they've never been able to do. They're connecting and building their employer brand with an emerging talent pool that happens to be in a highly strategic area for Westpac, which is Western Sydney. It's one of the largest growth economies in Australia. This is a great place for them to learn, to listen, to build case studies, but most importantly, to connect with real human beings. And that's what, at the end of the day, in this crazy digital world that we all live in, is what everybody craves. And it's being achieved in this room today.
Well, I'd like to thank you for putting together this ecosystem of all the important components of the economy in one place. It's like we've done a little micro-economy exercise right here. Thank you so much for putting it all together. It's an amazing vision, and I personally would like to see, as a small business advocate, that this gets rolled out across numerous tertiary education sites. So good luck, and we'll be keeping an eye on the progression of that.
Fantastic. Look forward to sharing more days with you.
Thanks, Dominique.